put to death. Four are put to death. It had to be a Britisher to come and tell us Indians what's the rate of female infanticide in our country. Now coming to the point, what does Quran speak about female infanticide? She cannot quote any verse. I challenge her to quote any verse from the Quran which says female children should be put to death. In fact, if you read Surah Takwir, see I'm going with quotation. Sasreen Manasreen only says Quran says that, Quran says this. How can a layman who has not read the Quran, or even if he has read the Quran, where will he find which verse says this, what she's saying? So you have to take it for granted. Give benefit of doubt that the Quran does say that the sun revolves around the earth, or you have to agree that it believes in female infanticide. If you read the Quran in Surah Takwir, chapter number 81, verse number 8 and 9, it says that when the female child, when she's buried alive, and when she cries out, for what crime has she been killed? On the day of judgment, she'll cry out, for what crime she has been killed? So female infanticide has been completely forbidden in Islam. In fact, all sorts of female infanticides and killing of children has been prohibited. It's mentioned in Quran, in Surah Al-Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 31, as well as in Surah An'am, chapter number 6, verse number 151, which says, kill not your children for want of sustenance. It is Allah who will provide you and your children for sustenance. In fact, Quran rebukes the thought of a person rejoicing on the birth of a male child and his faith being sad on the birth of a female child. It's mentioned in Surah An-Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 58 and 59. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Father Pereira wants to say something on this particular issue.
I just want to make a general comment, which I think is important at this stage. You often hear people say, oh, the Quran says this, which is an obscurantist thing. Oh, Hinduism says that, which is against progress. Oh, you can prove these things from the Bible and so on. Be very careful, firstly, when you hear things. A, often these are vague statements made, as Dr. Naik has pointed very clearly, which have no reference at all. That's the first thing. Secondly, often religious scriptures are used by politicians and are used by obscurantists to support their own prejudices. Classic instance of racism and the Bible. You know that a lot of Western Christianity through the centuries has been racist, and they have used the Bible to defend it. It's absolutely false, but here it is politics which comes to use religion for its own purposes. Remember what I said at the beginning. Every religion has a liberative element which can emancipate you, but can also oppress you, depending on how these things have been twisted. So I make this general comment because often you hear statements like this, and then they will blame, okay, Muslims, say Muslims, what else? Or Christians, of course, Christians, or Hindus like this, or Sikhs, whatever. Be very careful, because this is the typical kind of prejudice, actually, which only, as it were, creates turbulence and does not help to clear any doubts.